It's a lightweight bout between Raging Al Iaquinta and Rafael Dos Anjos.
Are you ready?
So the fight is now underway. On one side, we have a fighter who does everything well, taking on a true grappler on the other side. It's going to be interesting to see how long he can keep it up with.
I mean, Damian Maia may be the most specialist type of grappler in the UFC. This guy resembles him in a number of ways. Let's see how he manages this fight against a guy that can do just about everything inside the octagon.
Opens with the left hand and lands flush. These guys throwing early. Man, it's almost like he's got a range finder out there. Just too easy as he connects with another good series of punches.
If you're boxing this guy and only boxing him, you will be in trouble.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman. Big punch lands through the middle.
So 1 minute into the fight, we've got a full-on brawl here in D.C. It's great for the fans, not necessarily for the gas tank if this thing goes much longer.
Not great for the gas tank and not good for the old noggin. You can't take so many upside the head, somebody's going to sleep.
Right there, his opponent's wobble chair.
He's hurt bad. This dude needs to grab. He needs to wrestle. He has to do something. He cannot take another shot like that. Now the damage is about to start.
Sound strike on the ground. Oh, man. This ground and pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
The problem is his opponent is not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, he creates this space to land these beautiful ground and pound combinations.
3 minutes remain in the round. Side control now. Artie's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Anjos has got him in a crucifix now, gonna go to work from the top. Side control now, DC. A lot of options at his disposal from here.
Yeah, he's gonna try to attack the Kimura here. He'll try to get him up on his right hip so that he can get pressure to... The Kimura is not the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
But now DC trying to isolate an arm.
Yep, he's using the Kimura.
This might just be a matter of time. Somehow stays in the fight. All right, full guard now, DC. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom. The Kimura is not the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
But now DC trying to isolate an arm.
Yep, he's using the Kimura.
Bottom fighter trying to pitch nicely done. Back to his feet. So 37 total strikes have landed for Al Iaquinta. RDA gets hit by that leg kick. May not be a bad idea to start to check some of these.
Nice head kick.
All right, so another swing and a miss. And I'd imagine if your gas tank is this low, you got to find times to try to preserve that energy and get yourself back to a place where you can actually dole out some damage.
Yeah, you got to get out of the space. Find places to rest, keep recovering. Get against the outcome, go to the place. Find ways to just recover so that when you have that next explosion, it actually has some meaning to it.
Nice kick there by Dos Anjos. Trying to establish that jab once again. Oh, beautiful jump with the ankle pick to get him down. Now we'll see where he chooses to from guard. Nice combination there. Everything he throws is with fight-ending intentions. Aya Quinta gets the takedown. Seconds now in round one. All right, well, he's got him softened up here. The horn sounds for the end of round one. All right, so let us now check out some of the action in that round, DC. There was a whole lot of it, including a stunner upstairs that nearly closed the show.
It was a lot of action. It was back and forth action, but the big moment was that.
All right, round two.
Look at him whip his hip.
Now his opponent's really on the ropes.
His opponent's on beat streaks. He's looking so bad. I don't know what he's gonna do to stay in this fight.
Postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now, the ground and pound starts.
Well, as usual, suffocating work from the top here by RDA. Connects with a right. Dos Anjos' pass attempt denied. Well, hard to win fights in mixed martial arts from the bottom, but nice work here in that position by Aya Quinta. Man, how fun is this to watch as he continues to dole out damage with the ground and pound?
Take it back to the days of guys like Mark Coleman, just beating people up in the ground and pound. This guy is a throwback fighter, and he's very fun to watch.
Yeah, the Godfather would be proud. I mean, how many can he take? Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's gonna start looking to land big shots from the top.
Well, it's one thing to have length, it's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Aya Quinta. Well, more often than not, when he has struck, he has landed 86 total strikes have now landed for Rafael Dos Anjos. And connecting on a pretty good clip as well, 55%, the accuracy rate against Aya Quinta. Try to establish that jab. Just over 3 minutes now to go in round two. Dos Anjos' lower jaw now starting to
show. He's starting looking to finish.
Oh! Beautiful diving strike lands.
Oh, got it! He got it!
All right, so he postures up here and now to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty from this position.
Oh, man, it ain't Dikembe Mutombo, but he is blocking all these shots coming
man,
his way.
Man, get that out of here. He sees it coming. You're going to have to mix it up.
Shake that finger.
Shake that finger.
Big knee lands there. Man, as he landed a high volume of strikes here in round two, definitely picking up the pace.
Oh!
Hook.
Oh, yes, now we're going.
DC, he's in a world of trouble now.
They say the straight moves are the ones that get there first, and it got right to the target. When guys actually go to their back, that means they're in trouble.
Aya Quinta's got his back.
What a fight.
Keeps going back to that jab. Oh, huge elbow!
Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him. Look at how fast. The only person I can do this to is maybe John. John, there's a weight difference. I don't know if you know jiu-jitsu too much. You miss a lot of your classes. If I'm gonna do this to anybody, it's Eddie.
Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. Close guard. Look at the torso on the right side. Major bruising, and it's only getting worse. Well, he's up, but he is hurting for certain. The finish could come at any time. And now trying to take the back. Oh, you talk about mixing the martial arts. Perfect strategy here. So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes on. Keeping busy from bottom position here. RDA going to work here from the full guard. Nice combination of strikes, mixing it up pretty well here. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Well, the ground and pound has been on point tonight. Good work here by RDA.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
All right, so pretty good damage here with the ground and pound. Nothing superficial about these strikes. They are intending to harm.
Oh, yeah, he's landing very accurately, and he's landing to get damage off.
All right, there's the end of the round. So it was a huge strike to the head that stunned his opponent and nearly got him out of there.
Yeah, that was a big moment. A big strike lands, his opponent's on wobbly legs. That is exactly what you want to see as you're walking back to your stool. Your opponent staggering back to his corner and being hopeful that he can get it.
Are you ready? You ready?
Third round on the way. Well, most fighters can't keep up this time. Oh! Oh, big diving punch to the head.
He's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, Johnson. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Although Santos's lower jaw is extremely swollen now. Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted.
All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Pretty good work with the strikes here off of his back by Iaquinta. Man, this is some serious ground and pound. He's trying to put this dude's head, like, through the canvas.
He's one of the better ground and pound fighters we have in the entire UFC, and you're seeing why.
Well, the ground and pound is there once again. Strong work here by Dos Anjos. Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now, the ground and pound starts.
Pretty good work with the ground and pound here by RDA. I mean, how many can he take? From the top here. Nice ground and pound by Rafael Dos Anjos. Man, this is some serious ground and pound here, DC. He's not just staying busy for the sake of staying busy. These strikes are doing damage.
Oh, yeah. No pity pack to this guy.
That's it. That is it.
He's done. He's done.
Pinpoint strike to end this fight. It landed flush. I'm not even sure the opponent only saw it coming, and before he could recover, the referee was in to stop the fight. So a huge knockout victory for that fighter here tonight. All right, let's get you some replays now. Certainly a lot for our replay guys to work with in the truck. This was a clinic tonight in terms of mixed martial arts acumen in every realm of the game.
And once he got to the top, he started to land brutal ground and pound until the fight was called off. Just a dominant performance from the top position.
All right, the official decision is in. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliano's called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 51 seconds of the third round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Rafael Dos Anjos.
Well, he's smiling ear to ear, and why not after a knockout like that?
Don't you know everything lag now? If it ain't put it to rest, Then big Ben jumped on 80. On 20, on 20, no maybes. Run it till it brings up. Come with me. Yeah, bad news for us on stage. Try play game, they don't play. We just get clinked up. It's 100,000. Low key on me, I flex. Touch 40, that's cool, what's next? New bro can't link up. What you heard about? LA 2Bs, that's next up. Keep low around me, that's bestas. Sound round, son, so I gotta sing 100,000 praises. My brother's 100,000 shaking. I can leave 100,000 vacant and still count 100,000 later. Pete the position on that piece. Started to start up on bench me. Is you saying? He sent me money through mail and if he said he checked me. Cause I got ends that I can't even talk about. Couple wins that I can't even talk about. Spend a jam for it when I ain't coming. Leave the man's on the run. Brooklyn from the nine if they ask. They lab on him, got the clip for the fashion. Run no problems, but I built with that.
It is a heavyweight collision between John Jones and Junior Dos Santos.
Ready. Ready to fight.
All right, so here we are, Honda Center in Anaheim, California. And when you come to certain markets, you better bring it, right? We got Disneyland around the corner. The UFC knows when they come to town in Anaheim that they better bring the stars. They have certainly done that.
They've done that time and time again. Some of the title fights in this arena, Velasquez versus Lesnar, Cormier versus Jones, Woodley versus Maya, Cyborg in the championship, Dos Santos versus Velasquez. So many people have come to this arena as champion and lost those titles. What history will you make tonight?
Lands a big right hand early. Oh, really using his reach advantage there as he lands the punch, DC.
I mean, he's cutting down the size with these beautiful leg kicks. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Ooh! Suck him out of the chute here. Oh!
He's giving him so many different things right now.
Oh! Man, he is so sound defensively. Nice job. All right, fighting out of the clinch here. And not for long. Nice trip to get the takedown.
Yeah, sometimes, John, you have a guy that is just so versatile that they can do these takedowns in so many ways. You saw it on full display right there with that trip.
So just over 20 total strikes have already found the mark for Junior Dos Santos.
Oh! He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
He blocks the punch. Oh, big left hook there. Just misses there with the left.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow?
Oh, that is as big a strike as he has landed thus far tonight.
Big, massive shot lands. Look at how tough his opponent is, though. Still standing, still in that fight. He has a commitment to kicking tonight, and it shows.
Throws a big right hand, but doesn't find its home. Oh, no. Minutes to go in the round. Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there.
Ooh, what a punch. Real nice body.
Punch is blocked. Well, that didn't take long. Dos Santos' lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling.
Nice right hand.
Oh, really making good use of his reach advantage as he lands the straight punch there. Jones gets hit with a kick here. Let's see how he responds.
You can really limit the mobility of your opponent with those leg kicks. Nice punch lands over the top.
Under a minute now to go. Well, he's doing a nice job here blocking these shots. The chin is tucked, the hands are high. Pretty good job defensively thus far.
Great job defensively. He's seeing everything coming.
Well, so an early lead for him here tonight. He came out aggressively and, oh! He's out!
Yo, whoa! That was nasty! What a performance!
Just an absolutely gorgeous shot to spell the end for his opponent. Crowd is absolutely loving it. He gets the near-perfect land. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming, but just the way he drew it up here tonight, saw that little crack of an opening and barged right through it to get the knock. So a seminal moment for him here tonight as he gets the huge knockout victory. That could hold up as one of the better knockouts of the year.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 30 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Chicago Santos!
Well, we congratulate him on a huge knockout here tonight. He'll probably keep that smile while he's sleeping tonight after what he was able to produce here.
He's gonna be smiling for a really long time. When you get a knockout like that, not only do you get the win, you also, most times, walk away with a $50,000 bonus check.
I'm ready.